In the description of fluid flows, we encounter various variables. Some of those are vectors, such as velocities and forces. Just like any number or scalar variable, vectors can be multiplied. However, for vectors, we can distinguish three types of multiplication rather than one. Those three are the inner product, the outer product, and the dyadic product. The inner product is indicated by a dot, and hence it is also sometimes denoted as the dot product. The result of the inner product of vectors A and B is the product of the length of A and B and the cosine of the angle between the two vectors. This result consists of scalars only, and so the outcome of the inner product is a scalar. Hence, another name that is sometimes used for this type of multiplication is the scalar product. Next, let's consider what the inner product looks like when we express our vectors in component notation. In that case, the product is the sum of three terms, one for each component. For each term, we take the magnitudes of the components under consideration for vectors A and B and multiply them. And again, as the magnitudes of the components are scalars, the total inner product is a scalar as well. So to summarize, the inner product does not only measure the length of both vectors, but also the degree to which both vectors are parallel. The outer product is indicated by a cross, and so the alternative name is cross product. The result of the outer product of vectors A and B is the product of the length of A and B and the sine of the angle between the two vectors. But the outer product also has a direction. It is a vector. This vector is perpendicular to the plane in which vectors A and B are located, and it points into the direction defined by the corkscrew rule or the right-hand rule. In this case, when turning from A to B, the direction is away from the observer. As the result is a vector, this product is sometimes also called the vector product. In component notation, the vector that results has three components in which each component only depends on the magnitudes of the other components of vector A and B. So, for example, the first component of the outer product vector only contains the second and the third components of vector A and B. And in fact, we see that this first component measures how different the two and three components of vectors A and B are. If both vectors would have identical two and three components, the first element of the outer product vector would be zero. To summarize, the outer product is a measure of how similar two vectors are, both in length and in the degree to which they are perpendicular. So a larger outer product indicates that two vectors have a larger difference in size and are more perpendicular. Finally, we come to the dyadic product. This is indicated by a cross inside a circle. But oftentimes, this symbol is left out, and the vectors are just placed next to each other, just as when multiplying two variables. The meaning of the dyadic product cannot easily be depicted. But it is important to notice that the direction of both vectors play a role independently. The result of the dyadic product is a second-order tensor. Hence, we also sometimes call it the tensor product. The components of this second-order tensor can be written down in the form of a matrix, but please notice that a second-order tensor is not a matrix. Where a matrix is just a collection of numbers in row and column format, a tensor is something that has specific properties in three-dimensional space. You can think of it just in the way as we think about a vector that can exist without a coordinate system. The components of the second-order tensor simply consist of all possible combinations of the components of vectors A and B. Hence, the tensor has 3 times 3 equals 9 components. Summarizing, a dyadic product occurs when the directions of both vectors are important. Now let's conclude with a short summary. The inner product of two vectors is indicated with a dot, and it yields a scalar, and so the alternative names are dot product or scalar product. The outer product of two vectors is indicated with a cross, and it yields a vector. Therefore, it has two alternative names, the cross product and the vector product. Finally, we have the dyadic product of two vectors. This is either indicated with a cross in the circle or without any operator. The dyadic product yields a second order tensor, hence an alternative name is the tensor product.